balls, downtown construction, bottles breaking, jukebox buzzing, cardboard sign says the Lord is coming, tick, tick, tock. Rumors turn, the mills back home, parking lot kids with the speakers blown. We didn't turn it on, but we can't turn it off, off, off. Sometimes I wonder, how did we get here? Seems like all we ever hear.
What's up, NASCAR racing fans? This is Ryan with NASCAR Authentics Reviews, and here are the rest. Well, I wouldn't say the rest because I don't have the Dale Jr. car, but I'll get into that later. But I have the last two that I was going to pick up of the NASCAR Authentics Wave 6, so I'm glad to find these, finally found them, because Wave 7 is already out, which is very surprising. Lionel is doing an excellent job of keeping things stocked. I just hope that this next wave, the cars will be just a little bit easier to find, if they can find that sweet spot between actual stocking to where you can actually find them, and to where you don't overstock, to where you just have a bunch of, say, Batman versus Superman cars. I don't know, because those just never sold. Those are pretty much, you know, peg warmers right now. But anyways, yeah, the last two cars that I picked up are the Denny Hamlin number 11 FedEx Toyota. Awesome that we have another Toyota. And the Austin Dillon Cheerios Chevrolet. And then also that number 17 you see there in the back, that is a 2008, I believe, car tomorrow. That actually found at Walmart at one of these expeditions that I was going on. I was really surprised to find that. That's, like I said, 2008 Winner's Circle. And they didn't even have it in the system, so they pretty much gave it to me for $2 because that was just a guess price. So, anyways, let's get cracking. And I guess we can start off with this number 17. So you can see right here, it is Matt Kenseth. It's been a while since I've had one of these. Okay, 09, 2009. So you can see Matt Kenseth, number 17, Roush Fenway Racing, and DeWalt. So another thing, Matt Kenseth is another car that I would like to see. We do not have any Matt Kenseth cars. Let's see if I can get this back open. Maybe a little bit harder than I was anticipating. A little bit louder, at least. Okay, let's see if we can get this back off. Okay, so there's the paper. And one thing that we have that's kind of interesting is we have this little helmet magnet thing that's interesting. It is a magnet, of course. But that's kind of interesting. Okay, so what the main goal is to look at this diecast, so we shall do that right now. Okay, so, you see right here, it's the car tomorrow. This is the first Ford that I have that has a swing in the back. I do have another Ford from one of my very first reviews of the Carl Edwards, number 99. But we'll take a close-up look at this. It has the DeWalt on the front with USG. Of course, you have the Ford with the grill for Fusion, and at that time the cars did not exactly look like their original make, so that does not look very much like a Ford Fusion, but I guess it's just a Ford Fusion engine, or Ford engine rather. But we'll take a look at the side right here. We got several contingencies, EA Sports, which we don't really see anymore. What is that, Dish right there? It's kind of blurry. Dish or Direct of some kind, 3M, K&N, kind of standard stuff, NASCAR Sprint Cup Series still, but 17 RL Carriers, Carhartt, which we don't really see too much of anymore, DeWalt, and Matt Kenseth re-signed with DeWalt, which was kind of cool to see that car back on track. But yeah, this is when he was with Roush Fenway and not with Joe Gibbs, but yeah. Excellent looking car. That was pretty good for $2 that I got from Walmart. That's kind of a throwback to me. Okay, so here's the old. This is the other car that I reviewed early on in my I guess, YouTube kind of career. But this is like the Spin Master, of course, with the Murica kind of wave. You can kind of tell that there's no wing on the back here. Front's still relatively the same. They're both Ford Fusions. And then, of course, you have the regular Chevy Impala with the wing on the back. This is Kevin Harvick's number 29. So, yeah, that is your Ford Fusion, Matt Kenseth, DeWalt. And we will take a look at the cars that you did directly come here for, which would be the Wave 6 cars. So, let's go ahead and take a look at Denny Hamlin. This is a car that I definitely wanted to pick up because this is the Daytona 500 winter car. And not the race version car, which I'm pretty sure may or may not come in future waves. I kind of hope it does because I do want to keep track of all the Daytona 500 winning cars. So, we got this car, and we have the Martin Truex Bass Pro Shops car coming in. So that may be a excitement factor for those stop-motion people that like to recreate races, because now you have the Denny Hamlin, and now you have the Martin Truex once that one comes out. So, let's go ahead and crack this open. So, and of course everybody knows that really, really close race between them two at Daytona. That was a really good race. But yeah, this is a really good looking car. I only found one of these. Probably the hardest car for me to find would be the Dale Earnhardt Jr. 88 Tax Slayer. I only saw that once. I only saw this one once. And I only saw that once. And that's because I found the entire wave at one of the Walmarts, which I was very fortunate to find. But really, I've only found these cars at two Walmarts. So hopefully Wave 7 will be just a little bit easier. And I'll be able to find those rather soon. A big congratulations to David Land for finding those. I'm looking forward to that review. And, yep, a really nice looking car. I love the purple and the orange. It's better than the Spin Master car that we got a couple years ago through, Spin Master. So in the original NASCAR Authentics. But, of course, we have FedEx right here. FedEx Express, Hamlin. So really not too much. You got EL mold, which is the better mold other than the PTC, which I don't know if they really do much of anymore. And, so I'm excited about having that Martin Truex Bass Pro Shops. That's another Toyota. And then the Skittles Kyle Busch. Hopefully I can find those, because that's another Toyota. And hopefully we'll branch out into some other new drivers, because it seems like we're kind of starting to branch out. Lionel's trying to figure out what kind of things that these people want that are buying their cars, whether they want new people or big name drivers or what, because now we have Ryan Blaney, we have Martin Truex, which we've only had one other car, and that was the Chevy from 2015. So we're getting some new drivers, and I'm happy for that. I really want to see a Carl Edwards, maybe in the next wave, and I'm looking forward to those throwback waves. But we will go ahead and take a look at the Austin Dillon Cheerios, because that is another excellent scheme that I would like to see. Now, I believe this only ran probably once. I know that Austin Dillon ran this once, and Ty Dillon has also run this scheme. This is also a paint scheme that we got through the Spin Master wave, although I never picked that up because I didn't collect at that time. But once again, another excellent looking car. So, you have the Cheerios here on the front with the actual Cheerio as the dot in the eye. Looks really, really good. I really like the color of this car, and I wouldn't really mind seeing this again on track. You have the American Ethanol, Bass Pro Shops right here on the side, Dow, Ream. I forgot what that was. The S. Safety Clean, maybe? I don't know. Cheerios, 3, and of course, what, focus on? Probably not, oh well, yep, so, yeah, Cheerios, so it's pretty basic sponsored cars. There's not really too many contingencies that overload the car, but I really like it. So hopefully we can get some new lower end cars. I really want to see a Kyle Larson. And if you look on my Instagram, you can also see the Wave 8 predictions that I've made, a Wave 7 predictions, in which I got two of those right. I guess that the Chase Elliott 3M car would be in there, and that the Dale Earnhardt Jr. Exalta would be in there. So, yep. So hopefully we will get some good cars in this next wave of Wave 8. So I can kind of be patient. You know, I can kind of wait till that comes out. But yeah, those are the three cars. And the other cars that we have gotten, actually I put the two Wave 6 cars, and then the other cars right here. We, of course, have the Kyle Busch. I put this over here with the other Joe Gibbs Racing car. And the Chase Elliott. And the Jimmy Johnson. And the Kurt Busch. So those are the cars that I picked up. All six of them. Except for the Dale Earnhardt Jr. Tax Layer. And I may still pick that one up, even though it only ran at one race during the Sprint Unlimited. So I'm not really too much in a rush to find that. But if I happen to, I may or may not pick that up. So thank you guys for watching. And actually, while I'm at it, before I cut this video, might as well take a look at the magnets. Magnets are the same as the other ones, but I kind of like these. They're kind of small. They are kind of neat, but we'll see how the hoods go, because the next Wave 7 will have all hoods. So a lot of people's walls and stuff like that will be filled with hoods and so forth. But yep, thank you guys for watching. All right, NASCAR Authentics Reviews, signing out. See y'all next time.